Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at valderbeebeshow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/valderbeebeshow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Good day and welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show. Hopefully you enjoyed the music while I was gone, but I'm back. I'm back with two guests this time. I've got Caroline Jurin and Ed Tarrant. They're here to talk about deadly drugs. So listen up and listen good. Caroline, I'm going to start with you. You're the executive director of the Virginia Board of Pharmacy, and you're currently serving as the NABP president. So you've got great information. What are the dangers of rogue online pharmacies and counterfeit medications, and how expansive is this problem?
It's a very extensive problem. There are numerous websites online advertising to people how to obtain prescription drugs. But the problem is most of these sites are not safe online pharmacies. They're illegitimate rogue drug outlets. In fact, the National Association of Boards of Pharmacy reviewed over 25,000 websites and found that over 95% of them are operating illegally. They frequently don't require a valid prescription, and what they're dispensing is counterfeit medication. It contains dangerous substances, might include fentanyl, which is an extremely powerful opioid that I'm sure you're familiar with, that unfortunately can cause patient harm and even patient death very easily.
Is it because of the ease and the easy accessibility that we feel comfortable ordering online? What's going on? Why aren't we vetting these things?
I do think there's a level of ease to just going online and ordering anything. But I think also with the high cost of prescription drugs, it makes sense that people are going online to try to find a cheaper alternative. And these websites do typically advertise in a way that lures people in to believe that this is a cheaper, safe alternative to just going to the pharmacy down the street, for instance. But that is not the case, and people need to be very careful. They might also claim to be a Canadian pharmacy. I think people think of Canadian pharmacies online as being a safe source, but these are not Canadian pharmacies. They may say that they are, but they're not. And people need to be very careful, and there's a website that they can go to, safe.pharmacy, for how to discern a safe site from an illegitimate site. And as we talk as a country about expanding legal allowances to purchase from true Canadian pharmacies, we need to be really careful to not increase criminal activity in this space online.
That's great advice. I'm going to switch over to Ed. Ed, I know you're a father, and I apologize so much for you losing your son to a poison counterfeit pill, but can you give my audience a reality understanding?
Sure. We lost our son, Charlie, in May 2020. He was 22 years old and went on a social media site to get a Percocet for his chronically bad back, which was bothering him that day. But he didn't get a Percocet. What he got was a realistic-looking counterfeit pill made of fentanyl. And according to our doctors, we estimate Charlie probably died within 15 minutes of taking that pill.
Ed, what do you want to caution the listening audience about? Because I'm so sorry, you've walked the walk.
That's right. And I think there's two things that I'd like to get across. One, these counterfeit prescription pills have really flooded the online world. So if you're going outside of normal channels for pain medications especially, you can pretty much bet that that's going to be a fake pill, and many of those are deadly. And in this day and age, sadly, just one pill can kill.
And thank you so much for sharing your heartache with us, and hopefully that helps someone else. That doesn't make it any better for you, but thank you very much. Mm-hmm. I'm going to switch to you, Caroline. Caroline, you know, this is heartbreaking that you go online, do something that's so in vogue, and you get those kind of results. Once again, what are some cautions and how to try avoid this?
If anyone is thinking about ordering a prescription drug online, they need to first go to the website safe.pharmacy. It's a great way to identify a safe pharmacy from an illegitimate source. So find the name of where you want to obtain the medication, type that name into the website, and it will tell you if it is a safe, recommended pharmacy from where you can legally obtain your prescription medication versus one of these rogue, illegitimate sites. And there's some additional educational resources on that website as well that'll help the public hopefully be able to discern these true safe pharmacies from these illegitimate sites.
Caroline Duren and Ed Terran, thank you so very much for talking about this, bringing awareness for this, and making a difference. I guarantee you this will make a difference. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.